Just recently, this channel got 8,000 subscribers, and that's just crazy. I think it's incredible. I'm so happy that so many enjoy the content and the videos for this channel. So thank you so much for subscribing, watching, and supporting my channel. And when I decided to do like a 2-year special celebration video, I started to think about the very first time for this channel. That was late November 2015, and then the first video was uploaded, and then 2 more videos in December. And after that, this channel had, I think, 2 comments maybe, and 8 subscribers. I just took a look in the YouTube analytics page. It was quite interesting actually to take a look at this particular time period of time, and I didn't think so much about this channel. I was quite uncomfortable speaking English. I mentioned that a lot in my first videos, but since I got very positive comments, 2 positive comments, and some requests started to be posted as well, that really frightened me actually, because there were requests about me talking more, and that was just what I didn't want. Scared to do. But anyway, there were these comments. There were 2 more comments in January 2016 that were really supporting me. made me actually post another couple of videos in February. Hard to say. February. So I posted some more videos, 5 more, and I started to get some more subscribers and some more comments. And one of these comments was about this globe video that I had just posted. One viewer was really positive to that video, and that comment encouraged me to make more map drawing videos, actually. My first one. And this map drawing video turned out to be a very well viewed video on YouTube later. And I guess that European map drawing video is the reason for many of you have found this channel. So I'm very grateful for that. And actually I'm very grateful for that comment that made me take the decision to go on with this map drawing, or this map related, globe related videos. And this viewer and subscriber from back then quite recently posted a second comment. Requested a sequel to this globe video, and that made me feel really bad, because I know at the end of this video, this first video, I had promised to go on with a second video, a sequel, where more continents and parts of the world the globe should be presented. But I still haven't done that, and it's been almost 2 years now, so I guess it's time for the sequel to the globe video. And since this will be like a nostalgic video, I have also brought this little Nivea box that was featured in many of my first videos. I just wanted to show you that. And also this German grocery store ad from fall 2015 from Netto Marken. It's written with Swedish names, Swedish geographical names. And here's the equator, blue, quite a thick line. and it's like taped on top of the plastic globe, holding the two hemispheres together. And if you look at the Earth, the globe, from this point of view, it's almost all blue, light blue, because this is the Pacific Ocean, and it's really big ocean, almost half the globe in size, with only water. Not only water, actually. There are a couple of islands, as you can see. One of the biggest is Fiji, and here I tilted a bit. The northern hemisphere is the Hawaii Islands, and to the west of Fiji, there's New Caledonia. Is Vanuatu and the New Hebrides. I point with a pencil instead. Vanuatu, New Hebrides, Fiji, and New Caledonia. And if we go to the north, we have Santa Cruz, Solomon Island. Relatively large islands here. And here we have a very tiny island, but it's written in capitals, and on this globe that means it's an independent state, and it's very close to the equator, but just to the south of it. It's Nauru. You can't actually see an island or a dot or something that will point out the island, because it's so tiny compared to this ocean. So it's just the name written there, Nauru. And we move along the equator, just to the south of the equator, but to the west, and we find Kiribati, also written in capitals, so it's a group of islands that it's the state Kiribati. And we continue to the east. There's the Phoenix Islands, the Tokelau Islands, that belongs to New Zealand. And we move further to the east. We don't find so many islands. It's quite empty area here. A lot of just the ocean. Starbuck is an island here. I wonder if the first coffee place, Starbuck, was opened in this place. I want to believe it was. And find some more islands, we can cross the equator, and then we find some more Kiribati Islands, Christmas Island, Washington Island, Palmyra, and the Line Islands. And I guess these group of islands are the first where a new date appears on the earth. So like, for example, the New Year's Day, the first day of the year, is first celebrated here in the Line Islands of Kiribati. Hemisphere, there are not many more islands than the Hawaiian Islands that I already have shown. So we cross the equator once again and go to the south of it, because here there's a quite large area of smaller islands. It's a French Polynesia. Island here is Tahiti, the Cook Islands, belongs to New Zealand, the Marquesas Islands, also French, and we go to the southeast. Really tiny islands. Easter Island and Sala y Gomez, Chile Island. And if we move to the west again, we find some more French Polynesian islands. And here find Tonga and the Tonga Islands, just east to Fiji. And to the north of Tonga, northeast of Fiji, is Samoa and Samoa Island. And we continue to the south and to the west. Now we're really far south of the hemisphere. And here you can see New Zealand. And compared to Sweden, I think this is the place the other side of the earth. So when I was a kid, I was quite fascinated of the thought of digging a deep hole in the ground, right through the earth, and see where you would end up, where on earth. And it would be somewhere, not on New Zealand, but somewhere in the ocean here. Maybe here somewhere, I don't remember now. But the closest country or land would be New Zealand. And if we move more to the west, we find relatively small continent is Australia. The west coast of Australia, the south coast, south east, Great Dividing Ranges, the northern bay here, Carpentaria Bay, quite distinct shape, and then the northern coast with some mountain areas here, and then back to the western coast, Perth. Cities and towns. There's a lot of them are here to the southeast. These mountain areas. So it's Canberra, the capital. But I believe that's not so big city. We have Melbourne here, and we have Sydney here. Okay. So if we go even more to the south, it's a fascinating continent because it's all covered with ice all year. Yeah, it's too cold for people to live there for a long time. And this is actually the most northern tip of Antarctica. The Antarctic Peninsula, and it's on this globe, it's called Joinville. Joinville. And an island that is called Ross. And some more islands in this area is the South Orkney Islands that belongs to Great Britain. And even more to the north here is the South Sandwich Islands. And a bit to the northwest of the South Sandwich Islands is South Georgia. And if we move to the east, potions. I guess it's the South Ocean or the... I don't know what this part of the ocean is called, because this is the Atlantic Ocean, and this is the Indian Ocean, and the Pacific Ocean, but I know some parts of it is used to be called South Ocean, I think. I don't know if the South Ocean is considered to be this part, but maybe it is. Anyway, if we go in the direction to the Atlantic Ocean, to the north, we find Bouvet Island, a Norwegian island here, and we find Gough, a British island, and Tristan da Cunha, British island. And this is actually a small island where there is a small population as well. And you could say it's the most remote place on Earth where people are living, where there's a population, because Gough Island has no population, and the closest neighbor to Tristan da Cunha is St. Helena up here. Or if you go in another direction, you come to the Cape Town here, and I guess there are some ferries or some boats going between Cape Town and Tristan da Cunha, but you have to wait for... I mean, if you miss the boat, you can have to wait for a couple of months before you can go home, if you live there. Maybe. And... here we have the Prince Edward Islands, South African island, and here to the east is the Crozet Islands, some French islands. Wow, here's McDonald Island. I haven't seen that before, and of course I want to believe that the very first McDonald's restaurant was opened in this place a long time ago. And the Heard Island, the, I don't know how to pronounce this, Kerguelen, French island, and I would like to go a bit to the north, to the place in the ocean between the A and the N letters, see, it's the O-C-E-A-N-E-N. Swedish word for the ocean. And between A and N we have New Amsterdam, small French island, and we have St. Paul. And now we're back at the Australian west coast. Let's see if we can find some more small islands. I'm quite like to trace islands, small islands. I don't know why. Sometimes I think that islands and the oceans are more interesting than the north and towards the equator again. And here we have Cabos Islands and Diego Garcia. There are some small islands here, and some groups of islands just northeast to Madagascar. And Madagascar is a really big island outside the African east coast. I would really love to go to Madagascar one day. I've heard it's so beautiful there. And to the west, I mean to the east of Madagascar, it's Mauritius and Reunion, or Réunion, French island. And between the African mainland and Madagascar is Comorin. Some small islands here. And this is this huge continent, Africa. And I haven't been to Africa, but I would love to go there. Outside the west coast of northern Africa is Cape Verde Islands, Canary Islands, Madeira, and these places are popular tourist places from Europe and Sweden. Then you go from wherever you are to these islands, and here, quite isolated group of islands, Azorna, São Miguel, São Jorge, and let's see if we have forgotten some important islands. Yes, Ascension, British small island, and Saint Helena. And if we continue, focus on the southern hemisphere of the globe. Of course, I have to mention South America. Also, quite a big continent. But there aren't so many areas of land in the southern hemisphere. It's mostly ocean and water. But South America, of course, with this huge country, Brazil, and I also would like to go to South America someday. I haven't been there. I actually haven't been to the Southern Hemisphere. At all. There are so many places you would like to visit. You can't go to every place in the world, even though you want to. I would like to. But I've been... The most southern point I've been to is actually very close to the equator. Here in Southeast Asia, Singapore. It was a long trip from Sweden. I've been to Asia a couple of times, actually. I like to be in Asia. I really enjoy it. I haven't been to Thailand, actually. A lot of tourists go there, but I haven't been there. I've been to Hong Kong. See if I can find it here. Yeah, here it is, Hong Kong. And on this globe it says it's British, but today it's a Chinese province city. And I've been to Taiwan, here, this island. And I've been to Shanghai, this big city here, I guess the biggest city in the world, depending on how you count population, but in some lists I've seen that Shanghai is the most populated city. It's a huge city. And I've been to Seoul, South Korea. And I also been to Tokyo once, Japan. So I've been in this area of Asia. And it's also the most southern parts of the globe and the world that I have been visiting. I thought I would try something now with the globe. Not sure how this will turn out to be, but I'll try something new. I have some tape here. And I have a scissor. Face on the globe today. So this is supposed to be the eyes. And here So you can see the face of the Earth and the globe. It's happy, it's relaxing. Maybe it's a bit sleepy tonight. And I would like to give the globe some scalp massage that I think it deserves. I think the globe needs some relaxing head massage. So I start to trace a bit the coastline of India, South Asia, and Himalaya. Indonesia. Saudi Arabia. The Red Sea. Caspian Sea. Mediterranean Sea, and up here, the top of the scalp, Europe. British Isles, Adriatic Sea, Baltic Sea, Nordic countries, Iceland, and here. Start of the neck, the spine, Antarctica, and also Caribbean Sea, Gulf of Mexico, Cuba, cheek and the shin. Is to the top of the forehead. And we move to the right of the head to Kamchatka, Russia, Siberia. And some more on the neck, Antarctica, Asia, so I hope you found this as relaxing as this globe might have thought. You could tell by the expression of the face. Thank you so much. So much for subscribing, supporting my channel. Really grateful. Sleep well and take care. Bye. Mm-hmm.